I'll be your mistress, Clitera.
In the vomitorium, recycling her breakfast.
Fetcher me.
Fletcher who?
Get her now.
Huh?
Amscray.
Eat ray, Senator. I'll de-eat ray, act day. Keep it limp, Ray.
What a crude and unpleasant slave is he, Ray. Perhaps the Greeks were right to kill their servants and wait upon themselves. Of course, we know their heads were in their stomachs and they had no need to eat. Eat, Nox Vomica. I'm hungry. Dare I eat this scroll? It's sheepskin after all. Ah, but does contain a plot most distasteful to the Emperor.
Oh, God. No, let us no longer. Pox Domine.
Yes, and a pox upon your house too, virtuous vagina clitora, famous wife of Mucus Bruto. Can we talk?
Barely, with all these slaves underfoot.
Were we deep in Greece, we'd eat them.
Prolongus, you're up with the cock.
Yes, I rose early.
Have you come to tryst again like we did last summer?
Gods, no. My head is in another place. And where's this household's head?
As always, down the hall, to the right. Still in bed.
Still in bed? When all of Roaming's in the streets to celebrate the Emperor's pre-victory parade and Bruto's yet abed?
Yet abed?
Yucca puck.
But not yet asleep.
Ah.
Oh, Prolongus. He had a frightful night. He babbled like an open book, would television, then fall into his dreams again, back and forth, sweating like a Trojan. He slept the night away.
I'll be a horse's ass. What did he say?
I don't know if I should tell you.
Oh, come, come, Vagina, be open with me.
Take it from the horse's mouth, dear partner.
Oh, Ruto.
For here I stand, stuffed like an anchovy with last night's capers.
Pimentos of the future.
I can't believe I dreamt the whole thing.
Your images make my mouth action for water. Let's eat.
Plethora, urethra, diarrhea. Run to the kitchen. Let the food flow.
Are we alone?
No, I'm here.
Quick then, for time may spoil the meat of our plot. Tell me the omen in your entrails.
I cannot, though it sits on my stomach like a vulture.
Then pluck it. And with the feather, I'll tickle your throat, and you can throw it up to me.
I shall.
Oh, you shall? Well, I'll just stand over here and proceed.
I dreamt of Caliuga.
You dreamt of the Emperor? It must have been a nightmare.
Nay, more a night game.
What?
Torches, illuminating a field of play. It was La Colosseum.
Who was fighting?
The senators and the angels.
Ah, just like now, and with our lions and Christians, too.
No, but a spectator said that the tigers had slaughtered the pirates there a week ago.
Ah, but Mucus, what of the Emperor?
He stood in the center of the field and supervised the raising of their standards while a female Nubian slave sang some foreign song of conquest, and everyone stood and held his hand over his purse. Then they all sat down. Save the Emperor.
Save the Emperor? Hardly a good omen.
Then amidst the very furor of the action, he stopped the games.
What?
Picked out a senator, raised his thumb high, and ejected him.
That's monstrous. And the people, of course, revolted.
No. No, they roared and showered him with the glittering tin bodies of their household gods. Some of them I recognized. Olympia. Old Bohemia. But Burgermeister? Der Pepper?
That a jerk with a thumb should have such power.
Yet there was a hopeful sign.
And that?
The crowd did not cry as here in Roaming, long live the Emperor, but rather, kill him.
Kill him?
Master Bruno! Master Bruno! The Emperor's parade is passing!
We can but hope.
Hey, come see! Come see! He's but a little reed away!
That little man is breathing down our backs.
Because we're on our knees.
And knees must rise.
Like kneaded bread.
Suddenly.
And dump the ump.
We are agreed. Come, let us watch this Caliuga pass.
I'm coming.
You've been watching and hopefully listening to Chapter 13, Series 4, Part 2, Program 6 of Escaping from the Declining Fall of the Roaming Umpire. This classical fiasco was made possible by a begrudged grant from USAC, U.S., U.K., Litmus Industries, a short division of Burns Psychotic Plastic. This is Freddie Burns. In Fall of the Roaming Umpire, Program 7, Chapter 15. Flatus and Bruto, determined to bring about the Emperor Caliuga's downfall, have just joined the mandatory pre-victory festivities at the Emperor's table in the hall of the Great Cafeterium, as they anxiously await the fateful moment when they can fulfill their destiny.
Another blowfish, Bruto?
No, Fluto. By the great god Mercury, I'll pass.
Yes, I've been passing a lot myself.
And now, boys, let's do the hunt! Let's do the hunt one more time, everybody sings! Come on, get up from under the table, we're
going to try to... By Pluto, dog of the underguard, he's going to make us sing that barbarian tune again.
He leads us like a fool,
and yet
we must sing along.
He's lost his self-control.
Can't get us back alive. I just have to sit here and watch this Roman pot boner.
We're on. Just saw myself.
Oh, yeah?
Yes.
Hey, well, listen, good, then I can...
Attila was sitting on his hairy throne.
He's
I'm the Hun. I'm number one. I said, come on, boys, let's hit the road to Rome.
He's
I'm the Hun. I'm number one. I say we'll rip us off some booty, then we'll come right back.
Son of a Hun. What have I done?
Oh, come on,
let's sack.
Do the Hun.
It's what the latest rages do the Hun.
Come on, Hun.
It's from the Middle Ages. No other guest can touch it. No other holds a candle.
I learned it from a visitor who learned it from a vandal.
Do the Hun.
It's what the latest rages.
Screw the Hun.
He's in his Middle Ages. No other girl will touch him. They'd rather use a candle.
Wait a minute.
Ah, he's getting on the table. This is our chance. Hand me the ketchup bottle.
Now,
not
listen,
now. Use your self-control.
I control the vertical. Watch me flip-flop. Ha-ha, Bison Noni. I'm having a vision.
Well, then, tell us your vision. Come, Caliuga. Television. 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 Television.
I see a tower. What an eyeful. I'm going to build a tower of power. And I shall rise to the top and direct the building of great networks and broadcast them upon the waves. One voice, one image, one emperor, one me.
And one is nothing.
What? Who gives me such poor reception?
I, Flautus Prolongus.
And I, Macho Bruto.
A congress of senators.
A couple of eggheads come to scramble my vision.
Exactly. You poach the people's power.
And there's no gold left to lay another egg.
I'll lay anything I want. All hail, Caliuga! I shall reign forever!
Hail and rain, the sky is falling, little chicken!
Bark, bark! Come on, team, play ball with me!
We're calling your reign on account of your game. Take this!
You throw a salad on Caesar?
Dinner's on the Emperor! Pass the ketchup, Heinz!
I bleed from 57 wounds! Et tu, Pluto? You lift your leg against me? I might as well be dead.
He's dead. The show's over. Long live the people. And now, at last, the wealthy and the powerful can speak for all.
Okay, Fred. You're on. I got the pliers jammed into the board.
All right, now look here. I don't know what's going on out there, but if someone has something to say, this is your local station. So just come down here and show everybody what you want.
That chance, Uncle Fred.
Did you see that, Clark? That's your kid.
Yeah, I didn't recognize him without his mask. Hey, that's a swell signal.
Well, if that's your boy, he's only next door.
Hey, listen, Danny, what you're doing is causing a lot of static. Why don't you listen to your Uncle Fred?
Huh? Yeah. Oh, that's right, Danny. Man, I'm sure that if you go through the proper channels, no one is going to stop you from saying anything.
What the hell?
What's going on?
Pirates are intercepted. Screen cleared.